Now we will learn how to edit a deposit we have already recorded. Editing a deposit basically means taking out or putting in one of the sales receipts or payments that was recorded with the deposit. Removing an item from a deposit is very simple. For example, let's remove sale receipt number 2 from the March 23rd deposit. Open the deposit detail and make sure the date pull-down option says all. Then scroll to the very bottom. The March 23rd deposit is at the bottom of the report because it's the most recent deposit that we recorded. Notice it recorded depositing the first 5 sales receipts. Sale receipt number 2 is the one we want to remove from this March 23rd deposit. To be able to do that, we double-click the thick black bold line and the Make Deposit window opens up. We click in the row of the item that we want to remove and make sure the cursor is there before we go to the main menu and click Edit, Delete Line. Delete Line will only remove that one line for $1,400 from this deposit. We click Delete Line and the total is recalculated. When we click Save and Close, we get the standard change message. And when we click Yes, we notice sales receipt number 2 has been removed from the deposit. If sales receipt number 2 is no longer part of a deposit, it means we put it back into undeposited funds. In the trial balance, I double-click the balance of undeposited funds. Notice sales receipts number 1 through 6 all have check marks next to them, but sales receipt number 2 no longer has the check mark next to it. That means it has been put back into undeposited funds and it is not listed on a deposit. Now let's put it back into the deposit. We have to first find that deposit in the deposit detail. Once again, open up the deposit detail and set it up as I mentioned before. At the bottom here is the March 23rd deposit, and that's where sales receipt number 2 belongs. Again, we have to open this up by double-clicking the thick black bold line. Now remember, this is the second window that opened when we originally recorded this deposit. We need to find the first window because when we removed the sale receipt from the deposit, it went back into that first window. That window can be reopened by clicking this button, Payments. When you click the Payments button at the top of the deposit window, you get back the original window that opened when we first recorded the deposit. Again, I suggest you change the sort order to date, and therefore it will be much easier to find. Sales receipt number 2 is the earliest one on the list. Just click on it like we did before, click OK like we did before, and notice the $1,400 from sale receipt number 2 has been added back to this deposit. When we click Save and Close, you get the standard change message, and when you click Yes, notice the deposit detail now includes $1,400 from sale receipt number 2. Of course, the order is now different, but the important thing is that sale receipt number 2 is back in the deposit where it belongs, and the total for the deposit has gone back to what it was.